Hello, my name is Jen Faust, and I'm a member of the Mankato Symphony Orchestra Board of Directors. For those of you returning, welcome back to part two of our 70th anniversary season opening concert titled Big Sky. And thank you for your patience as we navigate during COVID. For those of you joining us for the first time, we're glad you're here. The Mankato Symphony Orchestra is extremely grateful for the support of Instaprints and Prairie Lakes Regional Arts Council for their sponsorship of today's Music on the Hill Chamber Concert Series. Our next online chamber performance will be December 13th, and we look forward to bringing you our symphonic series back this spring. We are excited to bring you the gift of music today. If it soothes your soul, brings you peace, or comforts your mood, please consider giving Mankato Symphony Orchestra a free will gift in return. If you have the means to do so, we have provided your Senior Living Activities Director with remittance envelopes to make the process easy. Please check with them to make your donation safely and conveniently. Thank you again for being an audience member today and for your support to the Mankato Symphony Orchestra. Please enjoy the remainder of Big Sky, Part 2.
Franz Schubert's Sonatina in D Major was written in 1816, when Schubert was only 19 years old. By this time, Schubert had written many string quartets and lots of violin music. This piece is in a traditional form. The first movement, there's a repeated unison line in the violin and piano that just keeps repeating. The second movement is a beautiful song, and Bethel and I both have a chance to sing the beautiful melody. And the third movement is joyful and just fun. The special thing about Schubert is he's able to create the most beautiful music out of the most simple melodies. And I think this is a perfect example of that. Thank you.
Nadia Boulanger was not only an amazing composer, she was also one of the most influential music teachers of the 20th century. Amongst her students were Aaron Copland, Daniel Barenboim, Elliot Carter, Philip Glass, and Astor Piazzolla. And it's hard to imagine a more disparate group of musicians than that. And I think that's a great testament to any teacher. The three pieces for cello and piano come from 1911. And these are three wonderful vignettes that run the gamut of expression from poetic, lyrical simplicity to dashing virtuosity.
Thank you. As Musical America's 2020 Composer of the Year, Joan Tower is considered one of the most significant composers of the time. And I'm so pleased that Richard chose her Big Sky Trio as part of our program. Joan Tower is herself a pianist, and as a pianist, understands very well how to blend the sounds of the violin and the cello with a full range of the keyboard. She creates a powerful dialogue between instruments through her unique harmonic language and rhythmic complexity. Try to listen with open ears to gather the full impact of her musical message.